All right, here's part one of the weekend work. As you can see, my fuel stuff came in. So got these in, and when I first opened the box, I saw TI Automotive Fuel Pump. Now on them, they say, I don't know if you can read that, but it's GSS 342, which is the model. It says Made in USA on it, but I saw that TI Automotive, and I was like, this Amazon seller pulling a quick one? I mean, but then I saw it says on this label, but it's a sticker, granted, new Walbro, etc., fuel pump. Then I flip it over to the back. And apparently TI Automotive is like a parent partner company or a parent company of Walbro, or Walbro is the parent company, something like that. But anyways, it's legit. I Googled it. So, scare over, don't have to send these back. So, if you paid attention before now, you remember I told you I was going to do my fuel coming out of this one single outlet. And I'm using this here Y. And this little hanger, oh, these pumps aren't going anywhere. This is snug, and they don't even clamp in with an actual like threaded clamp. They're just machine fit with an O-ring in there. I had to lube up the O-ring with some of this Earl's Assembly lube. This is what you use for like AN fittings. And holy crap, I had to twist and push them in and finally got them to seat in nicely, but they are snug fit. Got these socks installed. They actually have this little retaining clips on the back, which are nice. You just pop those on using a small socket and persuader. I still have to get my hoses hooked up. I have them in here. I got a couple different sizes. I bought these, which I don't think I'm gonna end up using, because I think what I'm gonna have to do is come down, loop, and then in. So I'll probably end up using two of these. So another one of these, I should have just gone ahead and bought two of them and just sent back what I didn't use. But anyways, I'll have to get one of those. My electrical terminals come in tomorrow, I think. So I'll be able to get that done. And the only thing that will be remaining is putting these hoses on. And I ordered, along with these, I ordered a little install kit, which comes with all this junk, which really none of it's needed, because this hanger covers it all. Normally you would put this thing on, this little sleeve on, and you'd zip tie it. So the only thing I really used out of the install kit is these socks and these. But these were an Amazon specialty kit. This hose I don't want to use, because I could actually probably make that happen like so. But I think this is just plain Jane rubber EFI hose, and the ethanol fuel eats that shit, so I'm not gonna submerge it. That's why I'm using this stuff, because these are the corrugated, I guess, nylon hose, maybe? I don't know. I guess the fuel doesn't hurt that stuff. It comes with these clips as well. I won't be using those probably, because I have these are the crimp style clips. I may use these just for simplicity. They're in the tank anyways, not seen, but I don't know. That's probably going to be overkill for these corrugated lines. Actually, the corrugated lines have these clamps on them, so I don't even know what I'm saying. I'll probably just use these here. Don't remember what I got a second one of these for. Oh, it was for the bottom of this in case I decide to needed to run another fitting for something. Anyways, so that's the fuel setup. My sender's in. I also had to go buy bolts because I don't have the right thread. They are, according to the fab guide, 10/32. I have 10/24. I have an 8/32. Don't have 10/32 thread. So gotta go buy bolts. So on to other goodnesses. Christmas came, along with the fuel pumps.
I got a whole bunch of shit from Summit. This is
Summit rated line. This is nylon. This will be what I use for my heater hose. It actually does have a steel core. See the little stainless barbs in there? I did not expect them to have that. So
means I'll have to cut them with some cut-off wheel.
Got my AN fittings. dash 10.
These Russell fittings with the silver front, which I wouldn't use elsewhere because everything on the car is just black. But these can go under the dash where they're not seen. And these are discontinued. I think I bought the last set off of Summit. They might have a few more of the straight ones, maybe. Either the straights or the 90s, I don't know. Must be the straights because I bought black 90s. I have several of these left and they're cheap, so I say cheap, they're at least half off. So if you need AN fittings, check Summits. These Russell fittings are pretty good fittings and they are discontinuing those silver and black ones. Another thing I bought, this. If anyone's ever had a Mustang and filled up at the gas station, you know the trouble of trying to fill this sucker up without it puking gas out, and of course without overfilling it because, well, it doesn't click off. And that's because of it not having a vent is why it pukes out, and this huge opening is why it doesn't click off. It just allows the fumes to back out, feed out, and doesn't click the pump off. Along with that, you have to hold the nozzle kind of like at a kick sideways to get it to feed in decently with the bumper here. So I did some Googling. I'll have a vent, so I don't need to worry about doing the other part of it, which is to put a vent on the tank somewhere here and then run a small hose up to the fill neck. And that allows it to vent better, I guess, than just venting up through the tube directly. You'd run it up to like the top so your filler would be past the vent hose. Anyways, this thing I got off of fillernecks.com or something like that. I don't know. If someone wants this thing, I'll post the link. But it has vents on it. It has a flapper and a small diameter opening for the fuel neck to actually sit in and lock into. And there's a guy that also makes these, so you don't have to do what I'm gonna do. If you want to, he sells them for around $100 or so, a little bit more than that, but he sells them pre-made. You buy the whole fill neck with this installed in it already, and his method is indenting. He takes a punch and indents it, feeds this thing in from the bottom, and then indents behind it to lock it in place. I'll be welding it. I've got to re-clock this tube because of my fuel tank, so I'll be cutting it up here, slipping this in, fitting it back together, clocking it the degree I need, and then welding around it. This is galvanized, pretty sure this is galvanized. They will be getting completely cleaned and stripped of their galvanized coating first. I'll pop this little clip, it's got a little locking tab there. I'll pop this spring steel out, throw it in the blast cabinet, blast the shit out of it. Same thing with this. And then I'll try to avoid hitting inside of there. I might just sand away this outside piece and not blast it. So I'd rather keep this thing galvanized since it'll be inside the tube. I can't really get to it. And I may just wear a damn respirator while I weld, just so I don't have to do all this. But this thing needs to be recoated anyways, so, and I'll need to spray over the weld. I'll probably end up epoxying it when I'm done. But yeah, so that's what came in this weekend. I also got an actual real Deutsch crimp tool, so I have no need for my China ones anymore, because apparently my China ones are shit. Go figure, they're China. And they won't do anything bigger than 14 gauge, and from what I read online, it's a matter of luck whether or not you break them crimping a 14 gauge pin. So I ordered a real Deutsch tool. It came in today. Very satisfied with it. It's quite nice. But yeah, so this is what else I did. Been out here all most of the day, and I haven't ground this down yet, but nice and flat. There's my hole over there for my AC, my hole behind this shit there for my AC, and all these little pinholes I filled in. The three you see that are big there is for my gas pedal. I welded this in up here, and I welded also down there, which you can't really see, but that little hole for the parking brake cable, and also those, these little like screw holes. I don't know what those were for,
but I'm pretty sure I won't be using them. If I recall, those right there on the tunnel were for the rear brake line, or yeah, I think it's rear brake line. It ran down the tunnel, I believe. There's another two that were down there in this area. I have no clue what those were for. Maybe that was all for the brake line as well.
I don't know. Anyways, I quit messing with this because I started, as you can see from the shitty welds, I started burning through. I had gaps that were too big. It was a bitch trying to fill it in by myself. These other ones I made were super tight fit and they were welded beautifully. But this thing, I was in a hurry to try to get it cut out quick. I really wanted to get this thing ground away and at least get a coat of filler put on this to start smoothing it so I could hopefully paint it tomorrow or get epoxy on tomorrow. I know I have rain coming. But anyways, I started breaking shit. I got to the point of where I was getting really mad and worried that I was gonna throw a hammer through my car. So to prevent causing further damage to my car to have to fix later, I quit messing with that and just came back here to do this, which is just part assembly, which I am so much more accustomed to and more relaxed to doing. This was like meditation for me. So anyways, waiting on screws, have screws for that. These nice little button heads fit beautifully. Waiting on terminals. I'm gonna have to order another hose because I'm stupid. And yeah, that's it.
Thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully next video I'll have the rest of the firewall finished up and epoxied so I can start mounting the AC for good. My AC lines should be coming in next week. And I feel like there's something else I ordered that I'm waiting on coming in. I can't think of it though. Oh, also got some AN baffles for my valve covers because I have breathers on the top. Since I'm going boost, I'm gonna hook up a air oil separator and I'm gonna have to plumb AN lines to my valve covers. So I got those in and I think that's it. Thanks guys. Later.